Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's lovely to have your company again. So in my last video in this series on voice and storytelling, I said I would be looking at another element of it and how we interpret song. That's what I said, and that's what I'm going to start doing today. Now, bear in mind, song interpretation, as I said, is storytelling. So it's similar to reading a book or watching a play or an opera or a ballet or something like that. But there's a trick to storytelling. It's short, it's tiny. And so in that short space of time, you have to draw your audience in to the story that you're telling for them. And that takes some doing. So I'm going to look at these elements that make up how we do story or song interpretation. So that is the story over several videos. And I will post the links of the videos that I'm referring to below the video that I'm talking about, so that you can understand what I'm referring to, what I'm listening to, and you hopefully can hear what I'm talking about. And I'd love to hear what you think, you know, of these. So anyway, there are several elements involved in any storytelling, but specifically in songs, because as I said, they're very, very short. So we have a short space of time to make a massive impact. Now, classical singers usually start with the tune, the music. And because I'm looking at Adam Lambert's voice and how he interprets song, and because he was also classically trained, I'm going to continue down that path. So I hope that's okay with you. So first of all, we're going to look at music, at the tune of the song, okay? So of course, yes, the lyrics are very, very important, and I will come to those in another video. But if you are a musician yourself, or you are a singer, or you're studying something to do with music, you might understand that looking at a piece of sheet music is almost like looking at another language. Now, not everybody can read music or look at a piece of sheet music and understand what it says. But even if you can't do that, even if you have to learn, like so many people do, learn songs by listening to them, you can hear the rhythm. And that's what the sheet music will tell you as well. The rhythm of the song. It will show you where the composer wanted you to go loud and where the composer wanted you to go softer. It will show you how the phrases work together so that you use your breathing optimally and that it may become part of the song, which is what it's supposed to do. So that's another element that we will look at in another video as well. But I'm going to tell you a short story quickly. I once studied with an amazing opera singer who said to me that if you view a song, or at that time I was talking about arias, if you view an aria, which is a song, as one note. Now, of course, you have to find the note within the song, but if you can view the song, the whole song, as just that one note, no matter what the other notes are doing, what the lyrics are doing, what the timing is doing, any of those things, if you can view that as just the one note, you have the perfect basis on which to hang your story. And at the time, I was very young. I didn't really understand what he meant. But as the years went by and I started singing more and more, I got to understand what he meant, and he was right. And so now sometimes it depends on the person, but I teach it to students of mine as well. So, as I said, I like to look at Adam Lambert's voice when I look at these elements of storytelling in song. So I'm going to look at how he interprets songs. So, but before you listen to these videos that I'm going to be posting below this video, I want to implore you, if you can, to close your eyes and to listen to the sound he's making. It's very difficult, I know, to divorce the lyric from the sound, but if you can do that, you will discover something magical. I promise you. So if you can do that, listen to the sound that he mingles with the sound of the instruments, because don't forget, the human voice is also an instrument. And I know that Adam regards his voice as an instrument as well. So it's very, very important to look at how his voice, his instrument, moves together with the instruments on the stage around him. Okay, so, and I want to take this opportunity now also to say thank you to all of Adam's fans who have suggested videos that I can use. Now, unfortunately, quite a few of those videos, well, quite a lot of those videos, have been removed from YouTube. So if you happen to find more videos that you think I can use in my videos and that you'd like me to have a look at, I would be most grateful if you'd send them to me. You can send them anywhere. I'm on Facebook and Instagram and even here. So yeah, that would be good. So the first one we're going to look at is a video that was suggested by Hana, and it comes to us courtesy of Glam Rock Baby's channel. It's called A Whole Lotta Love, from a long time ago. I remember this. I was at these concerts. But it shows amazing, amazing sound interpretation. So I'd love it if you could stop my video here and go and listen and hear what he's doing with the sound. It's quite stunning. So I would like you to listen to, see if you could hear the raw sexuality in his voice and the great way in which he uses rhythm just with his voice and how he builds tension with the sounds that he made and whipped the audience into a frenzy. Those are good things to look for. But I'd love to know what else you see as well. And then the next video was suggested by Julie, and it comes to us courtesy of Zyon's channel. I hope I've pronounced that correctly. I don't know. And although this one is a little bit more difficult even to separate the lyrics from the sound, if you're able to do so, you'll hear his fabulous interpretation, sound interpretation of I'm a Man. So again, I will post the video below this. And I want you to listen how there's warmth in every note. Again, close your eyes if you can and divorce the lyrics from the sound if you can. And listen, he gives us every nuance of everything a man can be just with the sound of his voice. So you hear it, you hear the softness, kindness, tenderness, fragileness, and the wild, passionate, loud bits that men are. And all of those things just through the sound of his voice. So can you imagine when we start looking at the lyrics? Oh. So, I know these are short and sweet, but remember what I said, they are not teaching videos. We are looking at technique only and the elements that make up technique and song interpretation. So thank you very much for your company today. It was lovely to see you all here. In my next video, I will talk more about how we interpret songs and the unique form of storytelling that songs are. So I hope you found this interesting. Let me know. And if anything in the video resonated with you and you liked it, I would love it if you please like and share the video. And if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe to my channel. It means a lot, because obviously we're spreading the love of voice and also the love of Adam Lambert's voice. And I think his voice is extraordinary and we're lucky to have him in the world. So until next time. Mwah.